Hello everyone, I am Dr. Nilanjana Bhattacharya Nath from Swami Vivekananda Institute of Modern Science. Today, I'll be discussing on DNA replication, especially rolling circle model of DNA replication. As we all know, DNA replication is the biological process of producing two identical DNA molecules from its mother DNA, and DNA replication occurs in all living organisms. But today I shall discuss about a special type of DNA replication, that is rolling circle model of DNA replication. So first, what is rolling circle model? This replication is a process of unidirectional DNA replication. And with this process, multiple copies of circular molecules of DNA or RNA, such as plasmids, can rapidly synthesize. Rolling circle replication was first described nearly half a century ago. Since then, many other genetic elements replicating by rolling circle mechanism have been identified, including bacteriophages, plasmids of gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria, archaeal plasmids, and eukaryotic viruses. It is widely used in molecular biology and biomedical nanotechnology, especially in the field of biosensing. Next, steps of rolling circle replication. So what are the steps of rolling circle replication? Number one, circular double-stranded DNA will be nicked. Number two, 3' end is elongated, which is known as leading strand. Number three, 5' end displaced. That particular strand is known as lagging strand, and this is made up of double-stranded fragments, that is Okazaki fragments. Next, replication of both unnicked and displaced single-stranded DNA. And lastly, displaced DNA circulates and synthesizes its own complementary strand. So if we want to elaborate each and every stages of rolling circle replication, they are as follows. A specific feature of rolling circle replication is its asymmetric character, manifested by the separation of leading and lagging DNA strand synthesis. Leading strand, also indicated as plus strand, and lagging strand as minus strand. Replication of the plus and minus strands is initiated at different replication origins, and the initiation protein plays a key role in plus strand replication. The process is initiated by initiator protein RepA, which nicks at the site called the double-stranded origin on one strand of the double strand. The initiator protein remains on the 5' phosphate nick strand, and the 3' hydroxyl end of the nick strand is elongated by the enzyme, that is DNA polymerase 3. Next, helicase binds with the region, and single-stranded binding proteins also bind to that particular site to maintain the structure. The unnicked strand acts as the template for replication, and 5' phosphate nick strand is displaced by helicase. The nick strand is completely displaced by newly synthesized strand and will remove itself from the original circular DNA by the same initiator protein, nicking at the terminating sequence on the nicked strand. Next, the nicked strand then form a new single-stranded circular DNA molecule. DNA polymerase 3 then use this single strand as a template to produce a newly synthesized double-stranded circular DNA molecule. The polymerase will start to move in a circle for elongation, due to which the process is named as rolling circle model. Next, what is the best example of rolling circle replication? As we all know, rolling circle replication is a process by which a circular DNA or RNA molecule is replicated, and this particular process occurs in plasmid and viruses genome. Though the best example is bacterial conjugation, where F factor is transferred during the process between F- and F+ cell, where F+ is a donor cell and F minus is the recipient cell. And the transfer will take place between donor to recipient. As I have discussed, the RAP protein induces a nick at a specific site from which replication starts. The elongation is unidirectional, and finally, termination of the leading strand synthesis involves a RAP catalyzed strand exchange to form a double-stranded DNA product and a single-stranded DNA molecule. The single-stranded circle serves as a template for the lagging strand synthesis. The purpose of general DNA replication is to produce two identical copies of a DNA molecule. This is essential for cell division during growth or repair of damaged tissues. As we all know, DNA replication ensures that each new cell receives its own copy of the DNA from their mother cell, and it is also applicable for rolling circle replication. Thank you.